So please welcome our first corporate speaker of the day. It is Andreas Schneider. He's a sales executive channel partners at Intel. Please welcome Andreas.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for the nice welcome. Yeah, so hello everybody. Hope you have all fun here at CloudFest. So let's start some of the business Intel is doing, which maybe not everybody knows from you. But before we do that, let's start with some questions. Who knows about silicon photonics? Omnipath. One. Optane memory. Oh, we're getting better. Okay, so obviously Intel is doing a lot of technology investments today and in the past, and only a few of them are arriving obviously on your side, mainly because the way how we are doing business through our partners, our OEMs. And Intel has a long history on building server and storage solutions for different verticals. And what I would like to make you aware of, this is not just a Me Too approach we are driving. So you can imagine if Intel is doing and building a processor, you also need to have a platform where you can test, validate your products. So for that, we are almost doing our own board and system development. And when those systems arrive into a kind of a production stage, then we are normally getting these systems into our partners, into our ODM hands, and they can decide then if they are using our reference design as the design they would like to continue with, or if they probably make changes and then make their own design. So I said a long history because we are in that business for almost 20 years this year. We have been starting with, you, some of you might remember you on these big Xeon Pentium Pro cartridges. So with just a few cores, or with the first generation, we only had one core that was driving that processing power. Then over the next decade, we went introduced Itanium as another product with the appropriate platform to drive the enterprise CRM database systems as a successor to IBM, and to make sure we are continue our investment in the enterprise cloud segment. Then in the mid of 2000s to 2010, we had a couple of experiments, experimenting with blade solutions for the market. Last but not least, our last generation of server solutions that was using our Broadwell CPU generation. What you can see here over the over these 20 years, so the density has almost not changed a lot. So the systems are still in the same 1 or 2U form factor, but the thermal envelope, the power, the TCO has been increased by far. I'm coming to that next. So why are those Intel server building blocks? So first of all, when we're doing the processor, we're doing the board, so we will be one of the first to the market with these solutions. You can also imagine that doing in partnership with the our OEMs, they have a longer validation cycle that it can take for getting everything baked in these systems. So there is a clear time to market advantage for customers who want to get hold of, want to sell Intel server solutions. Then usually when we start hitting our launch button, these products immediately become available in the market. So we are working with our distribution partners around EMEA. So we have 27 distribution partners who are getting you those products into your hand. We might not have the level of SLAs that you typically would get from an OEM up to next day delivery, 24/7, 4-hour response time, and so on. So we have only one level of SLA, because our partners typically buying those server solutions, they will either fulfill their own SLA or they will work with third parties in enabling these service level agreements. So we have a lot of technical expertise around these server solutions. Around the globe, we have approximately 6,000 people working on the development and the validation and evaluation of these server building blocks. And so on whoever is interested on sourcing and buying those server solutions from Intel, there will be also some commercial benefits for you. So we are able to give price projections and reductions wherever needed. So we call that normal meat comp and volume pricing tier. That's the only pricing support we have. And for our partners, our Intel technology providers, we are also getting your flex points. This is that kind of miles and more kind of approach. So you will be able to get additional points per purchase, which you can then use and buy other parts or invest into trainings or whatever. So now I would like to become a little bit more specific in terms of what are these server solutions. So on the left-hand side, you can see the board-only business. So that means Intel is building and selling server and storage components. So that means we are building the motherboard, the chassis, the RAID card, the host bus adapter, the backplane, the whatever is needed. And we make them available as separate components for system builders, for system integrators, or for those people who are running their own cloud stack and who are capable to use those components building on finished goods. Then we have level 6 systems, and for those who are not familiar what these L6 and L9 means, so these are the different level of integration that usually starts from L1 to 1110. Level 1 is board only, level 10 or 11 is then including the application stack. And what we can see here, so we have offerings for level 6, which is quite a bare bone type of system, and we have up to level 9, which is a full plug and play ready system. So in order to configure those systems and in order to make those systems real life, so we have different options for you to build those servers. On the left-hand side, you can see a kind of a very generic manual tool that allows you to go and make the configuration of a system. At the end, that configurator will give you a kind of a subset of master material order numbers and order codes that you can then use and call on your distribution partner for the fulfillment. So there is really no intelligence behind it. It's very manual. Everybody can access it from our worldwide intel.com support site. And then we have, for the deeper integration for level 9, we have what we call config to order. Config to order is quite new. It has been launched a year ago, and it allows you to fully configure and fully price those systems. We have, I will come in a minute to how that looks like, but basically you can, within the tool, you can not just configure the server. At the end of your configuration, the tool will tell you what is, if there was a failure in your configuration, it will immediately correct your mistake and it will give you the right option to make that configuration real. It's also automated in a way that you can submit it right from the tool. So you can ask pricing or you can ask other commercial things through the tool, which we are going to respond within 48 hours latest. So that means if you have your server configured in the tool and you need a better price because you have other offerings from our competitors, then you can tell us what the price has to be. And then we will adjust the price as end customer information has been proven. So simplify the process here. So I think we already covered most of that. That CTO is free of charge for everybody, so you need to register to get access to it. We also have, because we are putting everything into a kind of an intelligence that when it comes to CTO, you can imagine if we ship thousands instead of only tens of components into one place, and those places are the integration centers which runs around the globe. We have one integration center in New York and one in Hong Kong. We will have one in EMEA soon. And so by shipping those parts into bigger boxes and packages, that will obviously reduce our, first of all, our lead time, but also our cost. And those costs we are going to continue transmit to our customers using CTO. So that means, in a nutshell, at the end, when those servers are configured, you will see approximately 10 to 15% price advantage on a system that comes fully integrated through level 9 or Swiss CTO instead of just configure it out of components. So the lead time, something to mention. So how long will it take to build those up and running server solutions? So that varies a little bit on the availability of DRAM and other components. but usually we have a lead time at the moment of 5 to 7 weeks. We are trying to get better, but 5 to 7 weeks, given that everything is built out of EMEA, is already a quite good lead time. So here you can see how that config to order tool looks like. So on the left-hand side, you see the main system components that you can choose for the server, for the system. So you can go for the chassis, for the different form factors. You can choose for the server boards, depending on the different configuration. Then you can add the number and type of CPUs or host bus adapter, whatever. But the intelligence I was talking about earlier is on the left-hand side, you see these green check marks. And these check marks tell you if the configuration was successful or not. So let's say you want to add 8 hard drives or 9 hard drives or SSDs or whatever, but you only have added one backplane or you have only added one drive cage which can fit the maximum of 8 drives, then obviously the system is telling you, hey, do you need another drive cage to get the 9th SSD fit into? Also on the power supplies, if you go up on the thermal envelope by the CPU, that could require that you get into a more powerful power supply. Instead of 1100 watt, you then need 1300 watt. And this is also what the system is telling you. So it's a very easy to use thing. And at the end, you will get the quote. You have to supply a couple of information about the end customer, who is your reseller or distribution partner, the country which you are in, and then the requested quote date. And then that's it. You can submit this to us, and within 48 hours, you get your server, your personalized server configuration. I think we can skip that. We already talked about it. So the next step in evaluation of Intel server components and level 9 systems as pre-configured server solution is that we are working with the ISVs and with the vendors in the market to pre-qualify Intel data center blocks. So the Intel data center blocks are also highly integrated systems. They come plug and play. You just put them in the power plug, they will start, they will boot, and they are ready for you to install the application. So if we are doing a pre-certification, then we are making sure when working with the ISVs that these servers and the configuration will exactly meet the tested hardware and qualified lists of an SAP, of a VMware, of a Nutanix, and so on. So for that, we have a couple of data center blocks in total. We have actually around 20 different kind of blocks. We have blocks for high-performance computing, for vertical of cloud, for artificial intelligence, and then also for network function virtualization, which is mainly used in a telco MSP environment. So here is a quick overview about how many SKUs we have by these blocks. So on Microsoft Azure, we have around 6 pre-certified SKUs. So if you order them through our price book or through the distribution, then these server blocks are automatically certified. All you have to do is install your app and then get on. Same for VMware, for Virtual SAN or for ESX. So, and then latest ONTAP is a little bit older, but then just recently we launched Nutanix. We have a couple of blocks in preparation for Nutanix, which will follow our approach of integrated pre-validated systems for our partners, for our customers. So, I think we can skip that one. We already talked about it. So this is a good example of how what such configuration can look like. You can see on the left-hand side on the order codes, these are the order codes as one code containing the whole system. Then on the right-hand side on features, you see there are different type of CPUs that we are using and different type of memory configurations. These will allow you to run different type of setups in terms of maximum number of virtual machines you can run on these systems or maximum of database IOP capabilities that these systems are able to supply. Then, for those who want to have more information of what Intel is doing with our server blocks, there's a public shop where you can go. You can get a server catalog there where you can read all about what I told you today. You can even read that in more details. You will get information about the latest and greatest product we are launching. And with that, I would also like invite you to the Intel booth here at CloudFest, because we have some next generation of products that we are going to launch soon. For those who already have an NDA, you can come into our booth. We have a separate room where we are running a Cascade Lake, which is the next generation of Xeon scalable platform, launching in April. And we also have obtained persistent memory, which is a new way to do memory in a combination of DDR4 and 3D Crosspoint, which is the fastest memory on the planet right now. So with that, I would like to open for any kind of questions you might have. No questions? Okay, then I would like thank you and see you in the Intel booth.